Good morning, students. Today I'm here to teach you a new chapter. It's called tissues. We are going to learn about the plant as well as animal tissues. Okay, it is a chapter 3rd on page 23. As you know, chapter 1 has been removed from the syllabus and chapter 2 I have finished. So today we're going to start with chapter 3, page 23. You can all open to page 23. Okay, now first of all, what is a tissue? You know, our body is made up of numerous cells. Okay, not only our body, the body of all plants as well as animals is made of numerous cells. Now, these cells, some of these cells are similar. Okay, similar in structure and function. So, they come together and they are known as a tissue. So, what is a tissue? A group of similar cells which can perform a specific function. Is it clear? So, what is a tissue? Okay. Now, I shall tell you the information that you had studied in your lower classes. Okay, so it is this, that our body is made up of cells. The cells which are similar, they come together, they form a tissue. Tissues which are similar, okay, doing the same function, they come together, they form the organ. Okay, for example, the liver, the pancreas, here, okay, these are the organs of your body, the small intestine, the lungs, okay, they are all organs. Okay, now these organs, okay, come together and they form the organ system. For example, you can say the stomach is an organ, as well as a small intestine is an organ, the large intestine is an organ. Esophagus is an organ, your mouth is an organ. Okay, all these organs, they come together and they form what? An organ system, which is, we can call in this case, what I give you example, it's the digestive system. Okay, so that is known as an organ system. Now, our body is made up of many systems. Okay, for example, the excretory system, digestive system, respiratory system, all these systems come together and they form our body. Okay, so our body is made up of all these organ systems, and that is how an organism is made. I repeat again, our body is made up of cells. Okay, the smallest sized particle portion of our body is known as a cell. Cells come together, form tissues. Tissues come together, form an organ. Organs come together, form an organ system. Organ systems all come together and form the body of an organism. Okay, so similarly, it also happens in the plant cells also, in the plant body also. Okay, there are different cells. Okay, so we are going to study the first part of this chapter. We are going to study about the plant tissues. Okay, we are going to study about the plant tissues, and second part of the chapter, we will start about animal tissues. So, what is a plant tissue? Okay, what are the types, main types of plant tissue? There are two main types of plant tissue, that the meristematic tissue and the permanent tissue. Now, what is a meristematic tissue? These tissues, they multiply. Okay, they rapidly multiply and they produce new cells. Okay, new cells are being formed all the time from the meristematic tissue. Now, these tissues, the meristematic tissue, I will give you detailed example later on. Okay, they are present mostly in the growing tips of the plants where they have to grow rapidly. The second type of tissue is the permanent tissue, which are non-dividing. Okay, these are already formed, they are specialized and they are there. Okay, they are the permanent tissues. They have a specific function. They don't divide now because they have already grown. Okay, they no longer divide and produce more cells. Okay, so that's the difference between the meristematic tissue and the permanent tissue. Okay, now we study the first type that I told you, meristematic tissue. Now, as I told you, where are they present? They are present, see, at the tips. You can see this tip over here. This is a tip of the growing tip of the plant, okay, the shoot part. So, it is known as the apical meristem because it is known as the apex, okay, apex of the plant. So, it is found over here. It is known as the apical meristem. They can be also found at the sides. So, it is known as lateral meristem. Or they are in between, they are known as intercalary meristem. So, your intercalary meristem is over here, where they are helping the plant to grow up like this. Okay, and this side, and this is the lateral meristem helping it to grow sideways. Okay, so tips, intercalary, okay, at the portion over here where I am showing, and lateral, that is at the sides, helping the plant to grow in width. Okay, now where are these found? Found on the growing tips of plants, like the root tips of the root, stem and the branches, between the bark and the wood of the trees. As I told you, between the bark, okay, and the wood of the trees over here, they help in growing the diameter of the stem. Okay, they help in growing the width. You must have seen a plant, when it is grow small, it is so thin. As it keeps growing, the trunk part keeps enlarging. Okay, it grows in diameter. Now we shall study what are the characteristics of the meristematic tissue. Okay, the cells are small. Okay, here whatever these cells are here, they are very small. The cells are cubical. Cubical, you know, like a cube. Okay, so if you observe under the microscope, they will be like cubes. Okay, the nuclei are large. The vacuoles are absent. Vacuoles are the empty spaces. Okay, vacuoles will be absent because I told you they are rapidly growing. Okay, so they don't need to have empty spaces between them. Then no intercellular spaces. Okay, between two cells, that space is known as an intercellular space. That intercellular space will be absent. Okay, the cell wall is thin. Okay, between two cells, okay, the wall that is present between two cells will be absent. Okay, new cells are forming all the time. All the time there will be new cells forming. Okay, and once these cells are formed, okay, once the cells are formed, when they become mature, what happens to these meristematic tissues is that they get converted into permanent tissues. Okay, so from meristematic tissues, they become permanent tissues. Fine, have you all understood this? I hope you all have understood this. If you have any doubts, you can ask me later on. Okay, now we come to the types of meristematic tissues. I already explained, we'll just do it again. Apical meristem or the terminal meristem. Where are they found now? They are found at the growing tips of the roots, the stems, the leaves and the tips of the axillary buds. Then you have the cambium or the lateral meristem. You can see it is found on the below the bark and is responsible for increase of the diameter, as I told you. Now next, we go to the permanent tissues. Now, what are permanent tissues? They are the tissues that are already formed. Okay, from the meristematic tissues, they are already formed and they have specific functions. Okay, so we're going to study in detail about the permanent tissues. There are three types. There's the protective tissue, the supporting tissue, and the conducting tissue. Protective, supporting, conducting. Three types. Okay, so this is how, in general, the permanent the tissues in a plant will look like. It's just a generalized diagram. Okay, now first we'll study the protective tissue. What is a protective tissue? The cells have with thick walls. You know, the as the name suggests, is protective tissue. So it has to have a function of protection. If it has to protect, its walls should be thick. So obviously they have thick walls. Where are they found? Now obviously, what is their function? Protection. So where will they be found? They'll be found on the surface. Can they be found inside? No, they'll be found on the surface. Surface of what? It's a plant body. So surface of roots, stems and leaves. Okay, example is covering of leaves have a shiny covering. You have seen leaves. Okay, all of you all have seen leaves in your garden. Okay, now how these leaves look when they are fresh? They are obviously having a shiny covering. So this is obvious that there is a protective tissue in the leaf. Cork cells in the barks of the trees have a strong waterproof covering material. You've seen the cork cells. Okay, that is a hard woody covering of the trees. Okay, from the bark of the tree. It has got a hard covering. Okay, why is it hard? Because this part should not get wet. Okay, it should not be able to absorb the water. Okay, so it has got a waterproof covering material. So that cork, what you get is a waterproof material. It is covered with a waterproof material. So this is the first type of tissue, that is protective tissue. Its main function is protection of the plant. Where are they found? On the surface of the roots, stems and leaves. And they have thick walls. Now we come to the second type of tissue, that is a supporting tissue. Now under supporting tissue, there are three types: parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma. Okay, so first I will teach the first type, A1, that is the parenchyma. Now you can see the diagram over here. You can see these are the cells of the parenchyma. What is this? This is the whole thing is a parenchyma tissue. Okay, now this parenchyma tissue is made up of cells. You can see all these cells make the parenchyma tissue. Now you can see they are thin walled, okay, their walls are not so thick and they are oval or polygonal in shape. They are either oval in shape or you can say they are polygonal. Polygonal means having several sides. They have a single large vacuole. You can see here the empty space. This is a vacuole. This empty space is called as a vacuole. So they have a large vacuole. They are found in the soft parts of the plant. Okay, wherever the soft parts of the plant is, they are present. See the example I'll give you of the potato. You have all seen the potato plant which you eat, now that potatoes. That potato is made up of, what you eat is made up of parenchyma cells. Okay, so now you understood what is a parenchyma. Okay, so they store food in them. Okay, they store food, so they have thin walls, they are oval in shape, they are soft also. Okay, they are part, so where they are present is in soft parts of the plant. And they give temporary protection and support to the plant. They give temporary support to the plant. Parenchyma cells in the leaves are called as chlorenchyma. Now, supposing if these parenchyma cells, okay, if they are found in the leaves, okay, some of them are also found in the leaves. Okay, so these, they have a different name, then they are known as chlorenchyma. What are they called? Chlorenchyma. Because they contain chloroplast. You know the green pigment chloroplast? That is present. So they are known as chlorenchyma. This helps the leaves to prepare the food. They help the leaves to make the food. What is that? Chlorenchyma. So when parenchyma is present in the chloroplast, in the leaf, then they are known as chlorenchyma because they contain the chloroplast. Now we come to the second type of permanent tissue, that is the collenchyma. Now second part, remember there's a difference. What I said previously was chlorenchyma. This is collenchyma. There's a difference between the two. Okay. Now what is chlorenchyma? It was a type of parenchyma tissue. Okay. But collenchyma is different. Okay. Now what are these? You can see they are elongated cells and you can see they are thickened at the corners. You can see here, it is thick at the corners. Where are they found? In the leaf stalks and below the epidermis. Okay, little thicker parts. Okay, not like parenchyma. Little thicker parts below the epidermis. What do they do? Help in supporting the plant. They give support to the plant. Because at that case, that is why they have these thickenings at the corners. Understood? Now we come to the third type, that is the sclerenchyma. Now what is the sclerenchyma made up of? They are made up of long, narrow cells. You can see these narrow cells there. They are cells which have become dead. You know, for example, you can think about the coconut, the fiber of the coconut. You have all seen the fiber of the coconut. That is the sclerenchyma cells. They are made up of sclerenchyma cells. So now you have got a vague idea what is a sclerenchyma. Okay, they are dead cells. Now, cells develop very thick walls due to deposition of lignin. Now, there is this deposition of this material known as lignin. That is why they become like that. Their walls all become thick. This tissue gives strength to the plants. Okay, wherever this sclerenchyma is present, the walls, the tissue, it gives strength. The plant gets strength from that. Where are they found? They are found in the stems and in the veins of the leaves. Wherever they need strength to stand. Okay, so they are found in the stems and veins of the leaves. Parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma are called simple tissues as they are made up of only one type of cell. Okay, so all these three types, what I just taught you all, okay, the three types of permanent tissues, they are also called as simple tissues. Why are they called simple tissues? Because they will be only made of one type of cell. Like over here is made up of one type of cell. I'll show you previously also. See, all these in collenchyma, you can see this. Aren't they looking similar? Yes, they are looking similar. So, they are made up of only one type of cell. So, that is why they are also known as simple tissues. Understood? Because they are made up of same type. That is only one type of cell. Now, this is a different position. Okay, this is one cell you are showing. And this is many cells. Okay, sorry. This is a section of this. Okay, so don't get confused with this diagram. Okay, you will follow the diagram in the textbook only. Okay, let's not get confused with these diagrams. Now, there's a note about fibers and stones. Now, I'll explain what is a fiber and a stone. Now, you have all seen the ropes, mats. Okay, ropes, mats. Okay, what are these made up of? They're made up of plant parts. Okay, for example, a rope. What is a rope made up of? It can be made of jute as well as it can be made of coconut fibers. Okay, now what are these? As I told you, they are the sclerenchyma cells only. Okay, the sclerenchyma cells are these ropes and mats. The hard walnut cells, shells and the gritty masses in the skin and the pulp of the pears is also made of sclerenchyma cells. You have all eaten walnuts. Now, this walnut, this outer shell is actually what? It is a sclerenchyma. Okay, that is why it is hard. Okay, so this part is the sclerenchyma. This part is the sclerenchyma. Now, in pears, okay, this fruit known as pears, which we find nowadays in the fruit shop, you get this, you know, this outer, you will find dot, 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 dot little bit. And when you eat also, no, you will find a gritty, okay, like a, like something a little hard inside, not ekdam soft, okay, a little hard. Okay, so these are made up of sclerenchyma cells. There's another name to this. It is also known as stone cells. Okay, because of that hard feeling, they are also known as stone cells. Okay, now we come to the third type of tissues, that is a conducting tissue. Okay, so meristematic, permanent, conducting. So let's study about the conducting tissue. Now, as the name suggests, what is the meaning of conducting? Conducting means to conduct something, to pass something, okay, to pass something from one to another. Now, why do these plants need a conducting system? Why? They will need a conducting system because, you know, plants, how do they make food? They make food with the help of water, sunlight, and what else? Carbon dioxide. Okay, so this water has to reach the leaves. You know, the leaves is the kitchen of the plant. So, this water has to reach from where? From the soil to the leaf. So, there should be a system to carry that water. Okay. So, that is why it needs a system known as the conducting system, or rather we call it the xylem. Okay. The xylem is one of the tissues that help to conduct the water. On the other hand, the food that is prepared in the leaves has to be taken to all the parts of the plant. Okay, the food from the leaves has to reach the fruits, the flowers, even the roots and the stem and all the other parts it has to reach. So there is a need for a transport system. Okay, so that is why there is a transport system which is known as a conducting system or a vascular system. And for this we need the tissue, okay, conducting or vascular tissue. So there are two tissues, xylem and phloem. The xylem, what does it do is it conducts the water. Okay, water from where? From the soil to the parts of the, to the leaf for preparing the food. So we'll study about the xylem tissue. How does the xylem tissue look like? The cells are elongated and they are thick walled. Okay, the walls of the xylem are thick and elongated. The cells form tubular passages for upward movement of water and dissolved materials absorbed from the soil. Okay, they sort of help in absorption. Okay, they help in absorption of the water. Okay, they help to conduct the water from one part to another. Older stems form wood and do not conduct water. So, once they become old, okay, once the xylem becomes old, it is unable to conduct the water upwards. The age of a tree can be calculated from counting the number of xylem rings. I think you have studied this in your lower classes. If you, like, this is a cross section. If you cut a tree transversely, you will find these rings. You can see these rings. These rings will help you to count the number of years. Okay, how old this tree is. They are also known as xylem rings or the annual rings of the tree. Okay, now this xylem tissue is again made up of four types of other tissues. Okay, now let's study the type of cells. Okay, the first one is known as the tracheids. Okay, now this tracheids, you can see here, okay, I'll be teaching you the details of what the tracheid is actually made up of, tracheids and their function. Then you have the xylem vessels, the xylem parenchyma and the xylem fibers. So, these are the four types of xylem tissues. Now, we come to the first type. What is that? The tracheids, I told you. They are made of elongated. This is how they look like. They are made of elongated cells and they are placed end to end. You can see one over here, end to end. They are forming a type of a tube. Okay, so they are made of tubes which are helping it to conduct the water. You can see the water is getting conducted from here up like this. Okay, so this is a plant where it needs a lot of water, so it needs to conduct the water rapidly. Okay, cells place end to end forming a tube. You can end to end forming a tube. They have lignified cell walls. Okay, there is a lignin and the cell wall, you can see here, there is lignin. Okay, a covering provides mechanical support. It gives strength also to the plant. Now we come to xylem vessels. The xylem vessels, the long tube like structures. Okay, these are long tube like structures. They transport the water and the minerals. They are elongated cells, okay, placed end to end, and they are hard, thick and lignified cell walls. Now we come to xylem parenchyma. Again, these are also help in conduction of water, but in this case parenchyma, they also store the food. Okay, whatever food is prepared is also stored in them. So that is about xylem parenchyma. And the last type is xylem fibers, which gives support. They do not do anything else. They don't conduct the water. They don't store the food. They only provide support to the plant. Now we come to the phloem. Now what I told you was, what does the phloem do? The phloem, it is helping to transport the food prepared in the leaves to the different parts of the plant. So now we will study about the phloem cells. What is their function? To provide passage of food produced in the leaf to various parts. What do they consist of? They consist of the sieve tubes. They consist of sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. Okay, sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. Okay, so you have to study all these names. Let's go further to each type of this. Now, first part was sieve tubes. You can see here the sieve tubes, they are elongated. Okay, they are elongated cells placed end to end and they look like a tube. You can see over here, placed end to end forming a tube. What do they help in? Help in transport of food from the leaves to all the organs of the plant body. Companion cells. You can see your companion cell just next to the sieve tubes. There is a companion cells. They are closely associated with the sieve tubes. They help in function of the sieve tube cells. Okay, they help in functioning of the sieve tube cells. Now we come to the next part, that is phloem parenchyma. Concerned with storage of fat, starch and other organic food material. Okay, what do? They help in storage of food material. Always parenchyma, remember, it is to do with storage. Okay, so they store the food materials. Next is the phloem fibers. Okay, now fibers is over here. Okay, now you can see fibers will always be thin and they will not be able to store food, nor they will be able to conduct. They will only be able to give support to the plant. Okay, so that is about the four types of tissues. Okay, phloem tissues. Now I have put this summary of the plant tissues. You can see, so plant tissues are mainly two types, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Under meristematic tissue, we have the apical meristem, the intercalary meristem, the lateral meristem. In meristematic tissue, we have a simple tissues, which are again divided into parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma, right? Okay, and complex tissues, permanent tissues are the xylem and the phloem. And here this parenchyma, this you don't have all these, so you can ignore this. Okay, so that's about this chapter. Thank you so much. And please do the assignment. Okay, you have to do the question and answers also for this, which I will be giving now.